Do you guys remember this set of pictures in the OML Embroidery University Facebook group? Well, today we're going to work on it, and we are working on number 2. But first, my intro. So the first thing you need to do is bring the image in. So I just clicked on artwork and brought it in. The second thing we need to do is to adjust it, because we don't want these other ones, these other cute dogs, as cute as they are, dachshund, hint hint, dachshund. We want to crop it out so we can focus. So select the image and then click crop, and you can see right here it's a rectangle. If you want to see the other shapes, you just click on the down arrow there, and you can do it in all sorts of different shapes. A heart might be cute, but for this one, we just want a rectangle. And when I start it, I want to make sure that the number doesn't get in there, just to make it a little more precise and make it easier for us to focus on. So click crop, and you can see there's a little square there. And we're going to left click, and we're going to drag, and I just hit it. And that looks really good. So done. That's the easy part there so far. Now there's more than one way that we can digitize this little dog, and I'm going to show you a few ways. So the first way is to take the image into Photoshop and spend an hour cleaning it up so you can auto digitize it. It works, but you have to have some knowledge. I don't think it took me an hour, but it did take a while. So now that we've got it all set up, we can do click to fill, click on it. And we've got 3 colors. That's fine. Let's merge this one with this one and click merge. So now we have 2 colors, which is what we want. Makes everything nice and thick, and we could still have the details, and click OK. And once you do that, all you have to do is click here, and it's going to take a minute. And where else did we miss it? You tongue? No. Maybe we'll zoom in a little bit and see if I can get it. I don't think, yeah, there we go. You have to zoom in a little bit. And look at that. We are done, and it looks really good. I like it. That's exactly what we want. However, you know, normally auto-digitizing is not going to work really well. I will put that doggy file in the OML Embroidery Facebook group. What I want to do before I do anything else is I want to take off all this underlay. Auto-digitizing makes a ton of underlay. And take off the pull compensation, and that'll enable our details here to come through. So that was easy enough. A few minutes in Photoshop, or you can go over here to graphics and you can get it done. But let's go back to the other one that we're working on. So depending on the size, there's a few ways that I would do this. Okay, so let's click on the letter M. And we are going to check the size of what we're doing. So M, and then click, and then click. So that's about 4. Hit a backspace, and there to there, and about 2.5. So that's pretty small. And hit escape to get rid of it. So this is a decent size, and there's a few ways that you can digitize this guy. Now you can see, obviously, you can't auto digitize this because it's quite blurry and it's quite pixelated, and it depends on the look that you want. Don, if he was digitizing this, he would do it with his pen tablet Wacom and do it freehand. And I'll just show you with my mouse a little bit of how he would do it, just to give it the look. And this you can do if you're working on a small design, and we're going to branch everything after. But isn't that cute? I really like how this one looks. I'll get Dawn to digitize it, and we'll put it up in the group. But isn't that really nice. I think it would look good. And for thicker parts, you can do a different thing. You can do more, or you can do a thicker background on it. Now, for the paws, I definitely would use a fill stitch on the paws, and that'll make it look better. You can't do the running stitch with it, but isn't that cute? So that would be my first way of doing it. This is how Dawn would do it. And this would only really work if it's smaller. It would work bigger, but the outlines wouldn't be thick enough. But you see how easy it is to do like this? And I'm just following along. And what you have to do if you're branching this is you just have to try to make sure that you keep everything, flowing. So you don't want to end here and then start over here, because that means it's going to have to make a path all the way back. So I'm going to add a little bit of fill stitches in here as well, but I'm just going to design it up and just keep going. This kind of feels like drawing to me. I don't mind it at all. And I think it looks pretty darn cute so far. A little circle in there. And then we've got some detail work. It may help you to zoom out a little bit, because it's kind of blurry. If you find, that's difficult, then zoom out a little bit and it'll clear up some for you. So far, so good. Nice and easy. Let's do his tongue. And I have auto scroll on. I'm gonna have to fix that. I kind of bumped and straight down the middle. And then up to his nose, and I'm just going to outline his nose because I'm going to want that thicker as well. So freehand, play around with it. It's really cute. It's really easy to do. Now I'm not using my pen and tablet. I am just designing it as I go along. And this little guy is adorable. So I'm going to say this is way number two. And I just think it's really fun. I think it's easy to do, and I think it's fun. Let me do his eyes so we can actually see that. So there, let me go back to select, and let's make this. Let's go to colors. Let's make it something really weird so you can see it. Isn't that cute? I think that's an easy way of doing it. So that's way number two. Obviously, you have to finish it up a little bit. The cool thing is, if we branch it, let's go to branching. So digitize branching. So where you want it to start, I started here, didn't I? Yeah, here, and we want to finish maybe here. And now that's all set up. And if you look over here, it's all in one piece. But you can change the stitching on it, which is really cool. So select the one piece. You can see if maybe a back stitch would look a little bit better. It kind of does. A stem stitch, well, that might be a little too fuzzy. Triple. Now, I really like the back stitch. Zigzag, just for fun. No, it doesn't like the zigzag. Backstitch. Backstitch is my favorite. So that's number two. So just to show you how I would do the nose. So digitize, close, shape, fill, and we'll leave it on to Tommy for now. So I'm zoomed quite a bit in there, but we're just gonna right click. It doesn't have to be perfect. I would suggest that you follow along with your stitches as opposed to the image. But you can, change them if you want. Now, that looks kind of weird, right? Kind of weird. But if we zoom out, it looks cute. I want to go to stitching and I want to remove the underlay and no pull compensation. I think the angle is fine. Let's see, auto jump, trims, that's fine. Fill, spacing, travel on edge, it doesn't matter. Now we are gonna have to put that in order, of course, but so far, so good. Now I need to see the rest of my rest it. Let's go this way. The rest, there, that's what I want. So just move it out a little bit. And I don't want to change the stitch length, but I want to make it thinner. And I do want to travel on edge, because if we don't, then we kind of have this weird underlay looking thing. And to even make it look even better, that's actually pretty nice. Travel on edge, you see how it changes. We can make the length of it random. So let's click on this. I don't know if you can see it all. It's a little bit off screen, but we want to pick something random like this, number 38. And it just changed the different stitch lengths. So that's how I would do the thicker parts. So it's almost like a drawing. So the paws, I would do it the same way, change the angle of it. These dark parts in here, that's what I would do. So it's an outline and a fill, and I think it would look really cute. Hey, hold on a sec. I'm going to interrupt myself to show you guys how Dawn decided to digitize the dog. And it's pretty cool. I've sped it up so we won't spend, he spent, I think, 27, 25 minutes digitizing, and we don't have that time. So we're going to do it a little bit faster, but enjoy and watch Dawn's talent at work. So yeah, Dawn kind of digitized it a little bit differently than I thought he would, but you know what? Everyone sees digitizing in a different way, and I think he did a fantastic job. So far, that's three different ways: auto digitizing, freehand tool digitizing, and Don's way with the satin stitches. So stay tuned for part two coming up next, and there's a few more different ways of digitizing this dog. I hope you guys like this class, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.